good news is that human clinical trials can start as early as July 2020 for India's first COVID-19 indigenous vaccine that's been developed by Bharat Biotech.
The research or the ICMR has partnered with Hyderabad-based Bharat Biotech International Limited for the vaccine's clinical trials.
Dr. Krishna Ella was born to a middle-class family of farmers hailing from Thiruthani, Tamil Nadu. He first set out into the world of biotechnology through agriculture. Krishna, who is currently the chairman and managing director of Bharat Biotech International Limited, said, "My initial plan was to keep farming after studying agriculture, but due to economic pressure, I joined Bayer, a chemicals and pharmaceuticals company, as part of their agricultural division. This was the time that I got a scholarship from the Rotary's Freedom from Hunger Fellowship and went to study in the United States. After completing his master's at the University of Hawaii and his PhD at the University of Wisconsin-Madison, Krishna returned to India in 1995. In the same interview, Krishna points out, "I did not have any intention to return to India. It was my mother who asked me to return and pursue whatever I wanted. So I came back to India with a business plan to create a cheaper hepatitis vaccine, as there was a heavy demand for it in India." Krishna set up a small lab in Hyderabad with the medical equipment he had, and that was the beginning of Bharat Biotech. The company submitted a project proposal for ₹12.5 crore, with the hepatitis vaccine rate at $1, while the contemporaries were priced at $35 and $40. We didn't get the funding we expected, so finally we turned to IDBI Bank, who funded us with ₹2 crores, he explains. In just 4 years' time, the vaccine was launched in 1999 by then President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. The company supplied 35 million doses for the National Immunization Program at a price of ₹10 per dose, and has supplied 350 to 400 million doses in total to more than 65 countries. In 1996, Dr. Krishna had put forth an idea to the then Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister, Chandrababu Naidu, to set up a biotechnology park devoid of polluting industries. Soon, he received approval and land from the Andhra Pradesh Industrial Infrastructure Corporation to create the knowledge park Chennam Valley. The first industry to be set up at the park was Bharat Biotech's hepatitis vaccine plant, followed by the ICICI Knowledge Park. Today it is home to more than 100 knowledge-based industries, with multinationals like Novartis India Limited, Bayer Biosciences, to the Indian giant ITC. Chennam Valley has become very important as far as biotech parks are concerned in India. Bharat Biotech has now become the first company to manufacture a preservative-free vaccine, Rivac BMCF Hepatitis B vaccine, launch India's first cell-cultured swine flu vaccine, manufacture the world's cheapest hepatitis vaccine, and was the first in the world to find a vaccine for the Zika virus. The company has also in total supplied 3 billion doses of vaccines globally. Dr. Ella has been awarded more than 100 national and international awards, which include BioSpectrum Person of the Year in 2013, University of Wisconsin Distinguished Alumni Award 2011, Business Leader of the Year 2011, Best Technology and Innovation Award from the Prime Minister of India in 2008. While the world searches for an answer for the COVID-19 conundrum, we take pride that Bharat Biotech has come out with a vaccine. We hope the efforts of all the scientists will be instrumental in putting an end to the pandemic.